Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Wednesday, October 16th. It's made possible by the Vet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. It's a little chilly this morning, and the cool temperatures will continue in New Jersey, really through the rest of this week. Our chief meteorologist, Dan Zarrow, says it will also remain dry, but it will warm up for the weekend. Full forecast details are available on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. When the new drought monitor report comes out tomorrow, it is expected that a significant portion of New Jersey will be in the danger zone. There is little rain in sight. The latest sign of trouble is along the Manasquan Reservoir, where a dry lake bed shows how low the lack of rain has impacted water supplies. Managers say the reservoir is at a record low, barely 60% of capacity. Congress is warning of a persistent threat of terrorism in New Jersey and across the nation. The House Committee on Homeland Security releasing a multi-page terror threat report highlighting dozens of cases of homegrown violent extremists and foreign jihadist networks operating in the U.S. The report names three such cases involving New Jersey residents who provided material or financial support to Hezbollah and ISIS, and it says extremist groups are still working to radicalize people in the United States. We've heard from the family of that New Jersey Transit train driver who was killed in an accident earlier this week. They say NJT knew about the dangers of trees and other vegetation, what they posed to the trains running on the river line, and they did nothing. Jessica Haley was killed when the train she was driving hit a tree that had fallen out of the tracks. Dozens of passengers were also injured. Haley's family says they will sue New Jersey Transit for failing to protect her and the people who ride the train. New Jersey is wiping out another $120 million of medical debt for New Jersey residents. New Jersey using federal money through the American Rescue Fund to purchase the bundled outstanding debt of another 77,000 residents. It's a second round in partnership with the nonprofit Undo. Between August and now, the efforts have cleared $220 million in medical debt for 127,000 residents. Those impacted will get letters sent by Undo starting this week. They should start arriving in the mail on Thursday. More on how you can find out if you've qualified for this benefit at nj1015.com this morning. We have been warning you for months that sophisticated criminal enterprises tied to international drug crime and gangs have been responsible for the surge in home invasions in New Jersey. In Hamilton, Atlantic County, three people were home when robbers busted through the door. One resident pistol-whipped and beaten, another bound at gunpoint. The invaders demanding money from a safe. When they got it, they fled. Four suspects arrested in Philadelphia, all police say are linked to a violent gang with ties to the Dominican Republic. Walgreens is now upping the number of stores it'll be closing nationwide in the months ahead. The drugstore chain and its rivals are struggling to define their role for U.S. shoppers, who no longer look to them first for convenience. 900 stores were supposed to be closed. Now they've upped that to about 1,500 locations. We still do not know how many Walgreens pharmacies will be closing in New Jersey. New Jersey has a very aggressive goal when it comes to the sale of electric vehicles in New Jersey, and ultimately the goal is to have them the only new vehicles sold in the Garden State. But the very administration who put those aggressive goals in place is making it harder to buy an electric vehicle. Zero-emission vehicles had been exempt from sales tax. That's no longer the case. Also in effect now, a new yearly registration fee of at least $250, and that number will be going up. Environment New Jersey says these moves are taking the state in the wrong direction, but it's still a good time to buy an EV. The state's charge-up incentive still gives EV buyers about $4,000 cash on the hood, and the gap in price between gas and electric vehicles is getting smaller. Did you get your anchor rebate check yet? The payments have started going out. How do you know if you qualified and if the money will soon be on the way? There have been significant changes to the program and how you verify your identity to prevent fraud. One of the most common problems, an address change or a change in your banking information, marriage, divorce, death of a partner could also affect your payment status. I've updated my article with answers to the most frequently asked questions and links where you can check the status of your payment. That's on my page at nj1015.com this morning. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Wednesday, October 16th. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a great day.